Kynseed is a 2D sandbox game brought to you by ex-Lionhead Studios staff members Charlie Edwards and Neil Whitehead, two Lionhead developers who worked on the iconic Fable game series. The game takes from Fable's witty comical dialogue and awful puns and allows the player to explore the mysterious land as one of two twins, either a boy or a girl who has been adopted by an old man. The game promises to allow the player to live out any life that they want in this sandbox RPG. It promises to allow us to watch our characters grow, start a family, and watch the world and NPCs change around us. This is similar to games like Harvest Moon, Stardew Valley, Story of Seasons, Animal Crossing. Stepping off the path and into the darker reaches of the world promises to see us fighting monsters taken straight from British folklore, ancient legend, and rustic traditions, encountering mysterious creatures called the Fae, which currently are not in the early access version of the game. With Kynseed, you can actually choose to be an adventurer solely, you can be a business owner. Really, the game is promising a lot. This game will allow us to romance any NPCs and have kids with them and start a family. The most interesting thing about this, though, is that once you start a family, and if your character dies, you start playing as your child. If you don't have children and you choose not to have children, you get a game over. The world promises to grow and change, with characters dying and being born. This goes for the NPCs and the animals in the world. If you do wrong by a family, the future generations of that family will remember your actions. The game, similar to others in the life simulation genre, offer things such as an event calendar to keep you up to date with what's going on in the Vale, the area in which the game is based, also supporting a social system that we've seen kind of similar in games like Animal Crossing. Befriending the NPCs and learning interesting information about them or gossiping about other NPCs in the town, going as far as to say that their children and their children's children will remember your actions. Befriending animals is also featured in the game, with a higher friendship meter affecting the quality of the animal produce. If you've played Stardew Valley, or Harvest Moon, or Story of Seasons, then you'll find aspects of this game very familiar. But notice how I have arguably overused the word promise. This is because the developers are still constantly working on the game because it still is only in early access on the Steam store. This game was made by some of the developers from the Fable game series, and this really kind of shows in the writing of the game and how the NPCs talk to you. Honestly, the writing in the Fable games has been one of the best parts in my own personal opinion, being serious whenever it has to be, but also being kind of lighthearted and whimsical, and this kind of overall feeling of, ah, sure, it'll be grand. Since the game is still very much in its infancy, many of the features we're being promised are currently not in the game as of yet, such as the ability to age, marry, and start a business. The game currently only tasks the player with fetch quests, I'm guessing in a bid to get the player to go out and explore the world and interact with the various NPCs that inhabit the world of Quill. The game currently offers a fishing system, which honestly is quite confusing as it currently is. You have to aim with the mouse, click the right mouse button, and try and aim for the fish in the water. Once it bites, click the mouse again and hold it to reel in the fish to land. It feels very basic and easy, but again, we're still in the early days of this game's development. You have the ability to befriend cats and dogs. I personally was out late at night, close to midnight, and came across a band of wild cats on their merry way. After interacting with a cat, it began to follow me. Shortly after, I did collapse and I awoke in my bed to find that my furry new friend was sitting patiently in my home. I can only assume that if it weren't for my fur boy, that I would surely have perished in the wilderness. To the south of the town is the town square where the markets are held. Here you can buy seeds for your farm, you can also sell your own vegetables at whatever price you think the locals will buy them for. The game also has a blacksmithing and cooking minigame to craft new weapons and make delicious recipes, but both of these games are still really confusing and still very much in a prototype-like early access state. The most sought-after feature that we're all waiting for is the promise of growing old and dying and passing on our lineage to our offspring. That is, if we so choose to have children. And honestly, if this is the feature that you're most excited for, then welcome to the pessimism pack, my dude. Previously, I touched on how your actions will be remembered through generations, with your reputation being passed from generation to generation, your great-grandchildren being unable to go down the pub because you got caught stealing turnips from the spinster's garden. Seriously, do not do that.
Unless you know you can get away with it.
Or your great-great-grandchildren being given great discounts at the local shops because of heroic actions you decided on.
It all sounds very promising, and it was one of the reasons I kickstarted the game. The game is currently only still in its early access stage, and we don't get many of the features that will probably make this game notable or well known for, such as the aging and dying. Currently in the game, all you can really do is just fetch quests and ultimately try to get our sibling in the game to like us.
Seriously, why don't you like me? I give you presents like every day. The seasons in the game do currently change, however we will eventually run out of events to attend or do, more than likely because they're still not made yet and they're still under development. I would be worried that this game might eventually burn out before it reaches its peak. With a game this ambitious, it could be in development for years, and we might see people losing interest in it before it reaches its full potential. But all we can do is wait and hope for the best. Hopefully the devs are able to get more updates out as quickly as they can. If the next big update is more in-game events and the ability to age, then we will be okay.
As an article by Rock Paper Shotgun said on Kynseed, if there's one thing more frightening than dying, it's living forever. That, and spiders.
Thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, you know what to do. Click that like button or dislike button, share it, subscribe, and of course, I'll see you in the next one, guys. Bye!
I haven't filmed one of these face cam videos on my own in quite a while, and I think that shows. I can't even figure out how to turn the camera off.